fundamentally, the way you price a service is very different than the way you price a product. In this session, we are only going to talk about how to price a service business like software, consulting, advertising, mentoring, coaching, designing, or video production service. Usually, service businesses have been pricing themselves in three ways. They are time-based pricing, project-based pricing, and value-based pricing. Let's talk about time-based pricing first. This is simple. A certain task will take a certain amount of time, right? We multiply the hourly rate by the number of hours, and boom, that's our price. To charge this way, companies and freelancers must know how much they want to earn per month and divide it with how much hours they can work, and that is the hourly rate. The challenge is that when you think someone will take 10 hours and it take 20 hours to finish a work, there is a problem. If you are the vendor, then you have to explain why you took longer and why it cost the client higher. When you are the consumer, you feel like your expectations were not met and start to question the integrity of the vendor. Also, the vendor gets paid lower if he finishes the work sooner, right? That's like getting punished for being efficient. But this is the most traditional form of pricing, and businesses still follow it, though some of them are trying to break out and adopt other strategies for their pricing. Then let's talk about project-based pricing. It's a fixed pricing model, providing one flat fee for a specified project. This model is best suited when project requirements, specifications, and scope are definitive. This model provides a neutral ground between the hourly pay and performance-based pay. Before initiating the project, both project requirements and quote are locked. Reliability in price and efficiency in work is certain. This model requires elaborate and substantial agreement so that there is fair result to both client and the service provider. Every intricate aspect of the work should be included in the agreement so that both of them get the best results. Milestone-based pricing is applied here, where achieving every milestone requires a part of the payment. This will work best for you if you are quick with getting clients' feedback incorporated into the work, but sometimes the corrections go forever and you may have to say yes to additional requests without getting paid for it. And finally, let's talk about value-based pricing. This is one of the most discussed, and currently it's in buzz now. Value pricing is a strategy where you charge clients according to the value that they're going to get through your work. As example, you are building a software for your client. The client is going to use the software to automate few systems, which will save the employees ample amount of time, and they can be invested in other works to generate, suppose, two times the profit the client is getting now. Instead of charging on the hours you are going to spend to build the software or how much it will cost for you to finish the project, you figure out the exact profit the client wants to reach and charge around 2 to 10% of the amount as your fees. This is a collaborative process and takes a lot of question and skill to go through the discovery stage. We buy something when what we get is more important to us than what we give in return. If you ensure the success of the project, you can get paid with the fees you really deserve. The strategies may differ from industry to industry, business to business, and consumer to consumer, considering the economic condition, the risk-taking ability, and the competitor's market share. You can consider these strategies to price your service business and see what works for you the best.